In this video, we're going to explore the four main classifications of hydrocarbons. These are alkanes, alkenes, alkynes, and we'll finish up with the fourth one that's not quite as similar, that's aromatics. Okay, so we have alkane, alkene, and alkyne. These are all really similar, except they're distinguished by the types of bonds. So alkanes have all single bonds. Okay, it can be any length of hydrocarbon chain, but there can be nothing other than single bonds. Okay, alkanes are said to be saturated. That means each carbon has as many hydrogens as possible, so it's saturated with hydrogens. A terminal carbon has three hydrogens, right? So if you were to draw in the hydrogens here, we would have three here, we would have two, you'd have two, right? So all terminal carbons have three hydrogens, all internal or central carbons have two hydrogens. So this terminal one would also have three. All right, alkenes contain at least one double bond. Okay, so if we draw out this line structure, we could see a double bond present here. Okay, so an alkene is not saturated because any carbon that has a double bond is not saturated with hydrogens. Right, so this central carbon right here, this carbon, it already has three bonds, right? So one to this carbon and the double bond here gives it three bonds, so it only has one hydrogen. Same thing goes with the fourth carbon. It only has one hydrogen. So it's not saturated, it's an alkene, all right? We can further classify alkenes into cis or trans, all right? So the way that I drew this double bond right here is trans. This means that the carbons, so this carbon and this carbon, are on opposite sides of the double bond. Okay, this will be more clear when I draw out a cis conformation. So in the cis conformation, the two carbons are on the same side of the double bond. So this carbon and this carbon are both on the same side of the double bond. So this is a cis double bond. Okay? Let's move on to alkynes. So if alkanes have single bonds, alkenes have double bonds, then alkynes must be triple bonds. Okay? So if you have at least one triple bond in your compound, it's an alkyne. Just like alkenes, alkynes are not saturated because some of the hydrogens have been replaced by double bonds to carbons. Okay, and just one note about alkynes is that when you're drawing these structures, sometimes you'll see alkynes drawn like this. Okay, so this compound would be CH3CCH. Okay, and the reason it's drawn in this format is that this carbon, right, this carbon right here is sp hybridized. So it's a linear geometry. And we can draw this to imply that linear geometry. So if you ever see a compound that looks like this, just note that this bond, that right there, is another carbon. So there's not just two carbons here, there are three carbons. Okay, and let's go ahead and finish up with our aromatics. Okay, so aromatic compounds are a special class of hydrocarbon where all of our carbons are present in a ring structure, so in a cyclic structure. Okay, and not only that, every single carbon has sp2 hybridization. Okay, so if we think about the presence of hydrogens here, each carbon has a single hydrogen on it. And if we draw that out, right, so this carbon right here, it has a double bond to one carbon, a single bond to another carbon, and this single bond to hydrogen. So this carbon has an sp2 hybridization. And this carbon looks exactly the same as every other carbon on here. So this is sp2 hybridization. And as you'll learn about when you take organic chemistry, this arrangement of atoms and bonds is really, really stable because we can draw a resonance structure in these aromatic compounds, right? So I can easily draw a resonance structure in this compound where the position of the double bonds moves. So this double bond moves over to here, this double bond moves here, and this one moves here. So I have a double bond here, here, and here, right? So every single carbon atom is still sp2 hybridized. The structure hasn't changed, just the position of the bonds. So this becomes a really big deal when you take organic chemistry.